Hello dear friends, in this video we will make a moving obstacle. Let's get started. I will open sprites folder, then drag and drop the empty square to the scene. Now I wanna give you a little tip to position objects more easily. For example, you added an object to the scene. As you can see, it's quite difficult to align the object manually like this, but when we activate the magnet tool, we can easily do the alignment. As you can see, now we can quickly position the object relative to the pivot point. We can move it in smaller steps by holding down the control button. You can change the pivot point of the object from the sprite editor panel. You can align the object relative to its center or relative to the pivot point. I'm using the magnet tool for a neater alignment. I wanna change the color of the square. And I'll set the sorting layer as obstacle. Let's start the game in this case. As you can see, the player passes through the square and nothing happens. Let's make the square an obstacle first. I will temporarily disable the background. To make the object become obstacle, first I will add box collider to the object. And I'll activate its trigger feature of the collider. Then I'll change the tag as obstacle. Enable background again. I will add shadow caster component to the square so that it has a shadow. As you can see, the object now has a shadow. Start the game again. As you can see, the square has now become an obstacle. I want this object to move between two points, so I'll create a new empty object named moving square. Then I drag and drop the square object onto the moving square object. Right click on the moving square and create empty object named point 1. I'll duplicate the point 1 with Ctrl D shortcut. Rename it to point 2. Set the position of the points. I will create one more empty object named waste. I selected points and drag and drop on waste object. Now I want this object to move between point 1 and point 2. So I will create a script. Select square object and click add component. I will create a new script named moving obstacle. We will use this script later on spike object as well. Click on new script and click on create and add. Okay, this script has been created. Open the script. We will set the speed of the object with the speed variable. Target post variable is the position of the next point. We will create a simple algorithm. I created an array named waypoints. This array will keep the transforms of the points. I'll create awake function. Awake is called before start function. I set the size of the array by the count of the points. I pass the points to the array with the for loop. Let me write the whole algorithm and explain it on the example. I will use moveTwards method to move the object. Actually, if there were only two points, we could solve it with a simpler code. But thanks to this algorithm, we can add as many points as we want. When the game starts, I set point index to 1. So the point with index equal to 1 becomes our first target position. When the object reaches the target position, next point function will be called. The value of point index is increased by 1, so that the next point is set as new target position. If the object arrived the last point, the direction will change to minus 1. So the value of point index will decrease by 1 and the previous point will become the target position. When the object arrived the first point, direction will be equal to 1 again. This way it will move in loop. Okay, the algorithm is ready. save this script and back to Unity. Drag and drop the waste object to the slot. And set the speed. Start the game. Nice! As you can see, the object is moving between the points. You can change the speed of the object. And you can add as many new points as you want. So I'll duplicate the point 2 with Ctrl the shortcut to add new point. And set the position of the new point. And rename it to point 3. Start the game. As you can see, it moves between 3 points. You can increase the count of points as much as you want. I want the object to wait a while when it reaches its destinations, so I want to add some cooldown to it. Go back to moving obstacle script. I will create two new variables named weight duration and speed multiplier. And I'm gonna create an enumerator named weight next point. Thanks to enumerator, we can do the weight operations. This enumerator will start when the object reaches the destination point, and the speed multiplier will be set to 0. So this step will be 0 and the object will not move. The code will wait on this line until the weight duration is up. After the weight duration expires, the speed multiplier will be 1 again. So the object will keep moving. Okay, save this script and let's test it. Go back to Unity. I will set the weight duration time to 1. Start the game. As you can see, the object waits for a second when it reaches the destination point. If I set it to 0, it will continue without waiting. If you set the weight duration to 2, this time it will wait for 2 seconds and then continue. You can set the waiting time as you want. You can use the range attribute to make these adjustments easier. And so you can easily adjust the speed and weight duration of the object using these sliders. I think speed 2, weight duration 0.5 looks good. You can find the best values for you by trying. As you can see, the algorithm is ready and works well, dear friends. Now I'm gonna create a prefab from the moving square, so we can use it easily and fastly where we want. I opened the prefabs folder and I'll drag and drop the moving square on the project panel to create prefab. Okay, the prefab is ready. Now we can delete the moving square from the hierarchy panel. And we can easily add our scene whenever we want. The moving square obstacle is ready. Now let's create moving spike obstacle. We have created spike obstacle in previous videos. I dragged the spike obstacle to the scene. As you can see, the spike obstacle is still. Now we will make it movable. I follow the same step as I created the moving square. Determine the points. I'm gonna drag and drop the moving obstacle script to the spike object, because we will use the same algorithm. And I'll set the speed to 2 and weight duration 0.5. Start the game. As you can see, the spike is moving. I'm gonna create prefab from the moving spike. Now, we have two types of spike obstacles, fixed and movable. I carry moving obstacle script to the scripts folder. Alright, let's make a simple example. All we have to do is drag the prefab onto the scene and set the positions of the points. It's that easy. Start the game. Looks cool, don't you think? Let's become it easy. We are the boss. I will add checkpoint here. If you wanna learn how to make the checkpoint system, you can take a look at the channel. Okay, we learned how to make a moving obstacle in this video. I hope the video useful for you. For more videos, please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.